Big strides. Big strides. Can't be like that all the time, but today had to be done, so we did it. People hanging off the back of the LifeTrac. It's not, shouldn't be like that by design, and it's not, but today we had to do that, so we did. We need more lifting power for the LifeTrac. So we're constantly looking for ways to optimize that. Are you gonna cut all this out?
This is gold.
You're gonna get like 100 more views just because I said that. I don't know why I'm watching this.
I don't know. I was surprised it couldn't lift the brick press because it's good.
Long enough. I thought that kicked ass. That was amazing. What a human ballast weight.
Okay, here's Pulverizer. Alright, I'm setting that down. Okay, putting the forks on here. CEB, no, there to move. Alright, good. I mean, I don't really get nervous with it. It freaked me out the first time that this happened. But now I'm kind of used to sliding down the trailer.
Yeah.
Object just don't freak out. Hold on tight. But this is really why we got to make it a little narrower.
Yeah.
Perhaps reducing, like taking this outer frame member and putting it internally, and then cutting down on the shafts, these wheels, and just moving them in. If we could get it within 6 foot, that would be ideal. Because 6 foot is pretty standard. And obviously, if it was 6 foot, I would remain in line with all those notches on the trailer.
Where are we at right now?
8 foot. So even if we went in a half a foot, that'd put us at 7 foot, and I would still be able to get on the trailer pretty easy. Major advantages this has over like a commercial like Bobcat or equivalent is how wide the footprint is. You know, I'm gonna flip over sideways, it would take a lot. But you need to narrow it a bit. Thank you. this is going to go through the roof. Like, I have no doubt. Y'all rock. It's a pleasure being here with everybody.
Yeah.